Our next presenter is Sudha Kumari, who's a postdoc in Darrell Irvine's lab. Sudha grew up in a small village in northern India, which apparently is still not on Google Maps. She did both her graduate and undergraduate studies in India, studying life sciences and cell biophysics before coming to MIT. Her favorite planet Earth moment is bird swarms, and the title of her talk is T Cells in Immune Action, May the Force Be With You.
Okay, so when we fall sick, then the immune cells come to our rescue. And among these immune cells, one of the most important cell types are the T cells. T cells are like cops in our body. They perform surveillance and check for the presence of pathogens. And if these T cells do indeed find pathogenic signals in the body, they robustly trigger an immune attack and take care of the situation. How do T cells actually find these pathogenic signals in the first place? Actually, the only way in which T cells are able to do it is by making direct physical contact with other cells and exchanging chemical signals at the contact sites directly. Now, for the chemical signals to be exchanged efficiently, the contact has to be strong mechanically. Because if the contact is not strong, then the T cells just don't work, even if there are right chemical signals present there. And that happens in a number of immune deficiency diseases. So what I want to understand is, what drives the mechanical nature of T cell contacts? And how do these mechanical signals combine or crosstalk with the chemical signals that are going on across the contact interface of the T cell? To address these questions, I decided to look directly at the T cell contact interfaces using advanced microscopy techniques and also measure forces there using biophysical measurements. And what we saw was pretty striking. So we took the T cells in the dish, throw them with the partner cells that are carrying the pathogenic signals. T cell starts to crawl towards the pathogenic signal-containing partner cell. And when they interact, there's a physical contact. The moment T cell sees the pathogenic signal, immediately there's a burst of formation of these dot-like structures in the T cell contact interface. We were very surprised to see them because they had not been described before. When we take T cells from the disease cases, then those disease T cells do not make these dots. So clearly there was something important about these dots. After a number of experiments, we found out that these dots are actually like suction cups. And they increase the attachment of the partner cell with the T cell. So much so that if partner cell tries to go away, the T cell holds on tighter and tighter. And this cellular tug of war generates incredible amounts of forces. And these forces then trigger T cells to mount a response. In case of disease T cells, they don't have dots, so their forces are really messed up. In fact, they are messed up to the level of stormtroopers. And then we went ahead and identified the machinery that makes these dots in healthy T cells, took the components of machinery, put them in disease T cells, and behold, we are able to restore the forces and immune response in the disease T cells in a dish. So this is the exciting juncture that we are at right now. And going forward, of course, we would like to restore the response in the disease individuals, and not in just this disease, but a number of diseases where the T cell function is compromised, including cancer, all using the force-generating machinery of T cells that we have identified here. So I'll leave you with a thought that the physical contacts are important for all of us. For humans, they should be gentle. But when it comes to the immune response and T cells, they really need to make these fearsome contacts in order to mount a good response for healthy immunity. So think about it next time when you have an immune response going on. And I wish you that the force will be with you. Thank you.